to my channel. So as you can see by the title, today I'm going to be doing quite a big haul. Today it's makeup and skincare for once, so I've got quite a lot to get through. First I got this, which is the shapeshifter palette, the Naked Skin, which has been out for a couple weeks now. I've used this quite a few times now. I usually use the highlighter and the powder side. I haven't used the cream side yet, so I can't comment. So it's just, the packaging's the same. And you just open it up, and on one side it's got the creams, which I haven't used, and then the side has got the powders, which I've used the highlighter pretty much every day since I got it. And then I used these other shades today on my cheeks and my eyes, because I don't have a new palette for my eyes. And then also from Decay, I got their hair version. I was in the shop getting a quick demo, and about 5 people came in and all they bought was this. So I was like, obviously quite good. So I was like, you know what, I'll just get it. She tried it on me, on my bottom lashes. I was shocked at how like big they look. So yeah, this is really good. It just comes like this in this like chrome packaging. Brush is really quite thick for what I'm usually used to. I like lower lash because it's quite thin but still gives loads of volume. But this, obviously if you take the time to do it right, then it's fine. But yeah, this is really, really good. Okay, so next from Urban Decay, I got the eyeshadow primer potion in Eden. The woman in the shop told me this was really good for doing cut creases, so that's why I bought this one. It is really good compared to the anti-aging one that I've got. It's a lot thicker, and I'm not really sure of most of the difference in how my eyeshadow wears, but it's still really nice, and I'll have to keep an eye on that to see. And then lastly, from Urban Decay, I got this. It's the Meltdown Makeup Remover. And I've seen this on YouTube, but quite a few YouTubers have reviewed this because it's relatively new, and I really wanted to try it. And the woman in the shop said it was great, it's what she uses, obviously. They have to say that, don't they? So yeah, I like to use this every day. I have been for the past few weeks. Every day I take my makeup off, I use this first, and it literally just like comes off. Apart from mascara and eyeliner, it's a bit tricky. I have to kind of wear something else, which then there's something to get that off. But this just like wipes away everything. It's so, so good. So that's all I got from Urban Decay. While I was there, I was next to the Kiehl's counter, and I got this little sample. It's the Midnight Recovery Concentrate, and I used this for a couple of nights, but I accidentally spilled it all over my bed. So I really need to go get another one, because I think it was helping with my dry skin up here on my nose. So I'll need to go get a new one and see if it is that's helping. Randomly, I got this, I picked it up. It's the big version of the Garnier, I don't know how you say it, micellar, water, cleansing water. I use this every day, it's so good. I mix it in with a cleanser that I got from Lush, and it's just great. Obviously you can use it on your eyes, your lips and that, so this is what helps me get mascara and liner off, like tough things. This really helped. On a random note, I got this online because I saw, I think it was like on Instagram or something. These are the Clinical Skin Acne Pimple Master Patch. And it comes with lots of different size little patches. See, I can't see, there you go. And you just literally just take one off, put it on any spots. I haven't been that bad with breakouts lately, so I haven't had a chance to properly try these yet. I put it on a little like weird spot thing that I've got here, but it's been there for years, so I was trying to see if it would help it go away, but it didn't. I didn't keep on overnight, which I meant to. Okay, so next is something that I was so excited to buy. I've been wanting these for months. I got these, it's the Marc Jacobs Do You highlighter and the Tantastic bronzer. I got these from Harrods because nowhere else in the UK has one line. So this is the Tantastic bronzer. It's just beautiful. Obviously, it smells like coconut because it's a coconut collection. And I thought it would be, I was worried that it'd be really orange on my skin, but it isn't. It's quite good, good match. And the, I'm absolutely in love with these highlighter drops. I've used them just as highlighter, and I've also used it in my foundation, and it just looks amazing. There's nothing really else I can say about these apart from you should get it because it's just amazing. I think they're sold out now on Harrods as well, but it's just great. Next, I went to kind of on to skincare now. I went to Lush because I was going to buy stuff from Kiehl's, but it's quite expensive, so I thought I'll give Lush a try with their skincare because it's meant to be really good. I got this, it's the Ultra Bland Facial Cleanser. It just looks like this. Smells really nice. These were all about like £7 each. I got the smaller version of them just to try it out. This is quite dry by itself to use cotton pads with, that's why I use it with the water. But it's really good, it does the job. This is the toner water, Breath of Fresh Air, and I absolutely love this stuff. I've tried two or three toners now, and this one is just amazing. It's so refreshing. Yeah, it's just great. I'm definitely going to buy the bigger one next time. Again, it was only like £7 or £8, I think. I got two more things from Lush, so I don't have them in front of me. I bought an exfoliator, which I've got in my bathroom, and it is amazing. I can't remember the name of it, but it's got popcorn in it, and it just smells heavenly. And then I also got a face mask which I have to keep in the fridge, so that's downstairs. But the bad thing about them is it only lasts 3 weeks, and it expires within 3 weeks, so you've got to kind of use it. And you're only recommended to use it, I think, once or twice a week, so it's a big waste. So I don't think I'll be buying it again. However, I do like the exfoliator, it's the best thing I've ever tried, so I'm really happy with them. Okay, so next, I've got this order from Beauty Bay. First off, I got the Morphe liquid lipstick, which is what I'm wearing right now. It was discounted, so that's why I got it. I mean, they're cheap enough as it is, so £10.50, but I think it was down at like £6. So I got this in the shade Vanity. And you'll see me putting it on in my next video. But yeah, I really like them. I'll probably be buying more. Really, really easy to put on. And obviously a great shade. I'd rather get like a more nude colour next time rather than this like lilac pink, but I'm really happy with it. And then this was what I originally went on for. I've seen so many reviews about this, and lately I've had quite a lot of trouble getting to sleep and stay asleep. So I thought this would help. It's the This Works Deep Sleep Pillow Spray, and it smells lavender, it's got lavender in it. And it says, modern, fast-acting, natural way to restore normal sleep. Natural, expertly blended with essential oils of lavender, vetiver, and wild chamomile. Beauty, wake up refreshed. The best beauty secret there is. I don't know about waking up refreshed, but it definitely helps me get to sleep easier. Not one single night have I had trouble getting to sleep for choosing this. It doesn't keep me asleep, but then the box doesn't say that it should, which is just what I was hoping to get from it, but definitely helping get to sleep, which is a big help. So if anything people say, if you or anyone know has trouble getting to sleep, then definitely try this. And it wasn't expensive, I think it's £15, which is quite good, and it's going to last me a while. I mean, I use it every night, I use it for 4 sprays, and I only use about this much of the bottle, so it's definitely worth buying. If you need it. My next thing is I got an order from Cult Beauty, quite a big one. Quite big. So the first thing I got was these. It's the NYX matte blotting paper. I did bought one of the other ones, but it was out of stock. But this is just the matte ones, and I haven't given them to try yet. I bought them for like when I help a friend do her weddings and stuff, and like at work when I'm sweaty. So I'm excited to give these a try. And the next thing is, like, after months and months of seeing this on the internet, I finally got it. It's the Brazilian Bum Bum Cream. I just put a little one to try out. But this just smells amazing. It's like this, it's just keeps in that kind of skin. Perfume, like, the smell of perfume in it, it just smells amazing. And literally, I've used this about twice since I got it over a week ago, and about 3 days after I put it on, I can still smell it even after, like, showering. And it leaves, like, a really nice, like, glisten on your skin, so, like, a nice shimmer, which I didn't notice straight away actually. But even, like, my mum was like, "What is that smell?" I was like, "It's that cream I put on like 2 days ago." It's just amazing. I'm not sure about the effects that it has, like, on my skin yet, like, as in, like, smoothing it or whatever. As I've only said, I've only used it twice, but it just is amazing. It feels so good on the skin. And it goes a long way as well. I mean, I got the small bottle, which I was like, it's really small, but I've used quite a lot of it and just have loads left. Okay, next, I bought this. It's the Beauty Blusher from Beauty Blender. And not gonna lie, I spent £14 on this and I thought it was gonna be full size. It didn't say it was small, but anyway, I just didn't read it. But obviously it's for, like, blush, cream blush, but I don't have any cream blush. I used it for contour and cream highlighter, and it works amazing, obviously, as any of them do. Not sure if I'd buy it again, £14. I know the big ones are worth it, but you know, you never know. Obviously it's dark because I've used it the past 3 days. But yeah, I really want to try the marble ones that they've just came out with. I'm so excited to finally be able to get that because I've seen so many people using it. So yeah. I got this. It is the Caudalie Mask Peeling Glycolic, called Glycolic Peel. I haven't tried this yet. I haven't given it a shot. I got it because I really like peel off masks and stuff, so that's why I got this. Because a lot of them are obviously wash off, it's so much effort for me. But yeah, I'm excited to try this. Like a nice wooden cap. Doesn't really have a smell. My next thing is this. I bought this because Jamie Genevieve, who I watch, uses this a lot. It's the Way Hair Care Wave Spray. And I just got the small bottle, so obviously I haven't tried it. And like, I don't have naturally wavy hair. So yeah, I wouldn't say it makes my hair wavy, but it does kind of, like, poof it out and give it more, like, vibrancy. I think obviously maybe different if you've actually got, like, a little bit naturally wavy hair, and it looks better, but I'll give it a shot. The only thing is that, like, it makes it feels, it's really sticky, it leaves your hands really sticky, so I always have to have, like, hand gel when I'm using it. Obviously that's fine, it's not a big deal. Next, these are two like tester samples that I got sent with the order. The first is Becca Primer. I got two little samples. One is the First Light Priming Filter, and the second is the Backlight Priming Filter. So today I used this one, it's the Glow one. Backlight Priming Filter, and it only comes in these little circle things, but there's quite a lot of product in there, so I think I maybe put too much on my face, but it looks really nice. I'm not sure if I do notice difference actually. The skin is very glowy. I think I might actually purchase it. It's really, really nice, it's smooth to go on, it just, like, sinks into the skin. Obviously I've not tried this one yet, but I will tomorrow, and I'll let you guys know how it goes. But this one that I'm wearing today, it's a Radiance Booster and it blurs imperfections, and the other one brightens and revives and smooths and evens skin to look fresh. So let me know if you have used them and tell me how it goes, or how it went. But yeah, I really, really want to buy it now. And the second thing I got was this. It is the Alpha H Liquid Gold with Glycolic Acid Facial Pad. And it came in this little, like, packaging thing, this little packet. And I used this the other night after taking my makeup off, and it just comes in like just a little pad like this. And I'm not gonna lie, it is the worst thing I've ever tried on my face. After a second of putting it on, it burned my skin. Like, I feel like my face was on fire. And my face just started like appearing with all these spots that weren't there before. Like, it brought out all the spots on my skin, which I'm not sure is a good thing or a bad thing, but even about 15 minutes later, the burn was still there. I could still feel it, and all night I was just really uncomfortable. And I went online straight away to see what the reviews were, and like a lot of people were saying the same thing. So you know, it may help in the long run, but I'm not going to waste money on it. It's expensive, and I've got other stuff that does the same job and doesn't hurt my skin. So I won't be buying this, and I wouldn't advise you to either. That is my cult beauty order. In this box is two different orders from Tarte. One that I got about 2 weeks ago, one that I got today. I just put them together for easiness. I got this. It's the Drink H2O Hydrating Boost, and I use this at least twice a day before I put my makeup on, the last step after I take my makeup off. If I've not been wearing makeup, I use it before I go to bed, when I wake up, when my skin's just feeling dry, and I absolutely love it. It's so refreshing. It's such a big tub as well. I was really kind of on the edge about buying this because I was like, do I really need it? But I'm so glad I did. It's just amazing. So I got this. It's the Rainforest of the Sea Radiant Drops, and I do like them. I've tried putting them on after primer and before foundation. I've put them on with the foundation stick, and I've also put them in foundation and mixed it in. And to be fair, I've kind of been using it since I started using the foundation, so I don't know what it's like with or without, not without. But I mean, it's nice. It's not, I don't know if I'd buy them again, but obviously they'll last quite a while. But it's really heavy, there's a lot in it. You get to see on the wall. 30ml or 1.1 fluid ounce, which is quite a lot. So yeah, I'm gonna keep using it. And then I got this, the Amazonian Clay Full Coverage Foundation, which I've been wanting to try for ages. And yeah, it's really good. It's what I'm wearing today. This is just, it's just amazing. Definitely buy it. Then last but not least, from the last order, I got this. Which, if you watch my other videos, you've seen I already got one of these, but it was too light. I got Bella Tan. It was way too light for me. So I got it in medium beige, same as the foundation. And it's just great. It's just great. I use this if I just want like a really quick, easy look. Yeah, I use the Radiance Drops with this every time. I just put it on and swipe it over my face. It's so easy to use, it blends in great. It's just brilliant, I love it. Okay, so today, this is my order I got today. So to start with, I got this. It's just a little like travel size, tester size. I got it for like 19 pence, you know, at the end of the order, where you can just give you an option to get something cheaper. This is what I got. It is the Tarteist Lash Paint Mascara. It's such a strange little packaging as well. You just like pop it in and out. But I used this on my right eye today, and I love it. I love it just as much as the Urban Decay one. Yeah, I really like it. It's probably the first Tarte one out of the three that I got that I like the most. So I might end up buying full size. So next I got, this is the Rainforest of the Sea Filtered Light Setting Powder. I'm pretty sure it's new from them. I've seen a lot of people getting it in PR. Comes like this in this blue cap. I used it today. I'm pretty disappointed. One, by the packaging. Like, I know you could probably take this off. Oh, you can. But as of like this bit with the little holes in it, it takes forever to come out. It does smell amazing. It smells of vanilla, like their eyeshadow palettes and stuff, which I love. But it doesn't go well with liquid highlighter. I put the Marc Jacobs drops on my nose, and putting this on top just totally made it like crap and made my nose look just horrible. So tomorrow I'm gonna give it a try without using the highlighter and see if it looks okay. So yeah, I'm obviously gonna give it another try, but as of right now, I'm not convinced that it's that great. Next I got this, it's the Buffer, it's called Airbrush Finish Bamboo Foundation Brush. And I got this because I don't own any other Tarte brushes for foundation. And obviously I use their foundation the most, so I just wanted to get a brush to see if it obviously worked better than a beauty blender. I use this today on half my face and half the other half I use a beauty blender. And I have to say, I like the beauty blender side more because it was more full coverage. I don't know if this takes on the product or what, but it just looked smoother and yeah, as I said, more full coverage. It covered my redness a lot better, than the brush side did. Next, I got this, the Ready Set Radiant Mist. I'm sure I ordered the travel size of this and I'm actually quite impressed with the size. I thought it would be a lot smaller. But yeah, I absolutely love this. It smells of flowers. It's got a really like fine spray tip. Okay, I'm not sure about the taste. It's a really fine mist, so it's good. It doesn't like shoot out your face like other ones that I have do. Okay, so as you heard me say earlier about the oil that I got from Kiehl's, I think it really helped my dry skin. But because I ran out, I thought I'd try this. It's the Tarte Markage Oil. And obviously I know it's not for wearing overnight, putting on before you go to bed, but I think it says it's to help like dry skin. It helps firm, soften and hydrate skin. So I was like, right, I'll give this a try because obviously I've seen loads of people rave about it. And again, I got the travel size. And I'm actually really impressed. I haven't tried this on my face yet because I just got it today. I'm going to try it tonight when I take my makeup off. So I'm really excited. And then last but not least, I got this. It is the Titan Bright Clay Mask, which I've been so excited to buy. I was kind of like, should I, shouldn't I? I saw so many people review this, so I was like, I need to get it. And I'm shocked at how big it is. Show you what it looks like. So it comes with like the protector, and this is what it looks like, half violet, half gold. So yeah, I'm really, really excited to try that. I also bought the brush and spatula bit to go with it. It was like £15. So I'm going to do that tonight once I take this makeup off. This isn't makeup related, but I got it for my makeup room, so I thought I'd share it with you. It's just like a little poster that you can put in a frame and it says mind over matter. And it's marbled, which goes with my beauty room. It's from a company called Olive at Oriel, I think. And it's an Australian company. It was like £8 or something, I think. I seen it on Instagram or Facebook, and I was like, that's cute, so I'll get it. So I'm excited to get a frame for it. I don't have one yet, and I've got up on my wall somewhere. So I just thought I'd share that with you. Yeah, I think that's it. Obviously I'll share with you in my next video or on Instagram or Snapchat. If you add me on there, then I'll show you either me using the stuff or tell you what I think about it when I have used it. So yeah, I'll leave my socials at the end of the video. I post a lot on Instagram, so check out there. And yeah, my next video, I'll be using a lot of this stuff to do this look, you'll see. And I hope you enjoy it. I love doing this haul. I love doing this kind of video. I'm gonna keep doing it, you know, once, twice a month. So yeah, if you liked it, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, please, before you leave. And add me on socials, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.